I'm Ethan with Splunk Education. In this video, we will learn how to create quick and dynamic search results using the top and rare commands, two commands that share the same search syntax. The top command returns the most common values of a field or list of fields, while rare does the opposite, returning the least common values from a field or list of fields. Both commands can also utilize a by clause and optional arguments to further customize the output of your results. Let's take a look at a few examples. We'll begin by writing a basic search, looking for events in the web index with a source type of access combined. A list of events matching our query are returned. The field sidebar is located to the left of the returned events. Selecting a field name from the sidebar opens a menu with a few options, one of which is to create a quick report. The quick report options are great when you want fast results or aren't yet familiar with the command syntax. Selecting top values will add the top command to our search, returning the most common values for the selected field. The rare values report will add the rare command to our search, returning the least common values for the selected field. In our results, we see the rare command has calculated a count and a percentage of the frequency of values occurring in the events. Both of the quick report options also add a limit option with a value of 20 to our search. If there aren't 20 results, it will display as many values as there are. We can easily adjust or remove the limit if necessary. As an alternative, specifying the integer in the search is equivalent to using the limit option. By default, top and rare return 10 values and have a maximum returned result count of 50,000. Adding the show perk option with a value of F, or false, will remove the percentage column from our results. The show perk option defaults to true, meaning you will always see the percentage column present when using top or rare. The count field option will give us the opportunity to rename the field of count. Setting the argument to sum of products, we can see the count field has been updated. It's important to remember, anytime you are renaming a field and it contains a space, you will need to surround it with double quotes. We can also use top and rare to find the most or least common values across multiple fields. Querying the network index with the source type of Cisco WSA SQUID, we would like to identify the top combinations of username and web category browsed. Each of the results are completely unique combinations, showing the top 10 users and web categories overall. Finally, we'll run a variation of this search and introduce a by clause so now the results will be grouped by the field we specify. We want to show the top CS username values split by the X webcat code full field, so we'll add the by clause between the two fields. We also want to limit it to 5 web categories, so we add limit is equal to 5. Now our results display the top 5 users for each web category during the last 24 hours rather than overall unique combinations. We don't need both the count field and percentage value, so let's use show perk is equal to F once more and add count field is equal to total sites viewed. To help provide clarity on what the field value represents. Thanks for joining us to learn more about how the top and rare commands can transform your search results. For getting started guides and product tips, please visit Splunk Lantern. We also suggest you check out the documentation, watch additional videos on the Splunk How-To channel, and register for additional courses from Splunk Education. Happy Splunking!